practice, or standard practice for that matter, that ministers should be in Parliament to be able to respond to queries that come from the floor or regarding matters of national importance. Today, legislators were dismayed after only five ministers were sitting on the right hand of the Speaker to be able to answer those questions. This angered the Deputy Speaker, Right Honourable Anita Among, who prematurely adjourned the discussion and Parliament business on the whole to ensure that this is rectified. Our reporter has more on this anomaly.
I keep saying this and I repeat it again. This country is one of the countries in sub-Saharan Africa with the biggest cabinet and the biggest number of ministers in the docket of finance and internal affairs. I don't know whether we are proceeding well, Madam Speaker. When these people who have just been given dockets as ministers of defense and internal affairs leave, the government chief whip to stagger on floor of parliament keep asking for permission and referring for tomorrow.
Madam Speaker, when ministers come to the appointments committee, they talk heaven and earth. We should not be getting answers after a member raising a matter of national importance. That I know that the clerk's office is aware of this and the ministers are informed. We should not be waiting for another week because these are matters that need urgent attention.
When I was coming to Parliament, right on the compound of Parliament, I have seen several ministers within the precincts of Parliament. When you walk in Parliament, the ministers are not here. Right, Honourable Speaker, I think this Parliament and this House should take a strong, deliberate decision that some ministers must just attend Parliament.
Despite efforts by the government chief whip Thomas Taiba to convince Parliament to give ministers a second chance, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament Anita Mongen had no kind words for ministers and accused them of breaching the commitment which they made during vetting.
The Minister of Security to coordinate with other agencies so that they link up with the honorables and then we ensure
there's a procedural matter. People are being killed and we don't have a minister to respond. And you have the government chief whip here all the time coming to apologize. I'm not sure whether that is what he's supposed to do. If we cannot have the ministers in the house to respond to the issues being raised.
After establishing that ministers were not about to show up soon, Anita adjourned Parliament prematurely with displeasure over their conduct.
I am adjourning the House.
Right, that's where I am moving. Thank you.
I adjourn the House to Tuesday next week.
What's the plan?
MPs noted with concern that a taxpayer spends over 2 billion shillings daily to run Parliament, but only do transact no business because ministers dodge sittings.
What you need to understand is the cost of maintaining Parliament. Our budget now is more than 600 billion shillings. Dividing that money into the number of days in a year means that every single day the taxpayers spend 2 billion shillings on Parliament. That's the money we lose as a country if Parliament doesn't do its work. Unfortunately, this Parliament is the one that approved all these ministers. Some of them, I'm not even sure that they remember that they are ministers with a duty to perform.
We really have a lot of backlog, and we really have a lot of issues that we have to, you know, that have been communicated by the public, such that we follow up and we see a way forward. Ministers not being in public, not being in the plenary, is a very, very, very bad issue.
The House could not proceed because of the absence of the ministers. But the only thing that we can advise is that the ministers must know that it is their mandate to appear in Parliament on these designated days, because these days are prescribed in the law. They're in our rules of procedure of Parliament. So the ministers are aware that they're supposed to sit in Parliament at least every Wednesday and every Thursday afternoon. So we are calling upon them to respect that law.
Others called on Parliament to consider censuring those errant ministers in order to send a signal and deter the recurrence.
I'm for NRM, but this is just a great pain to Ugandans, because last time we were complaining that, please, why can't you give these things to younger generation? For us, we are here every day. We come, we present, we do everything, but ministers are nowhere to be seen. These are old people. They should go and rest. I'm telling you the reality.
It is a position that that must be squarely appreciated by Parliament. And if the leader of government business, the Prime Minister, can't direct her house, can't direct her team, then the Parliament may have no choice. We may have to fall into what the rules provide, what the Constitution states. If you have a minister who is not executing his duties, that there must be no reason to doubt that you are ineffective, so you are a waste cost on the taxpayers.
That is something we have to take on next. Some ministers need to be censored, because if they can't serve, if they are too busy for this house, then they deserve to get other people who can be reliable. So reliability is one of the factors why they were elected.
But the chief whip, Thomas Saiwa, defended his colleagues that the parliament is too small for 82 ministers to fit in. He added that many ministers were still busy in meetings with parliamentary committees.
Ministers are not only addressing issues of the plenary in the parliament. They are even addressing issues of the committees. But going to parliament to have lunch, someone has been in a committee up to 2 p.m. time for plenary. He rushes to parliament to have lunch. Then you, who has been moving around, you've been free, you had your lunch at midday.
Parliament was adjourned to next week on Tuesday, and the Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, who last chaired Parliament in June, will return to take charge.